Good morning. Welcome to a new edition of our show titled Speak of Africa. Brothers and sisters, we have another great show for you today. We're going to look at lawlessness and law in Africa today. When we look at the African scene, we are seeing that most countries are becoming lawless. As a result, there are a lot of problems happening. Take a look at Nigeria as an example. In less than 3 weeks, precisely on February 16, Nigerians will go into the polls to elect a new president. But already, Nigerians do not really want President Buhari to be their president. But this individual is already taking steps to rig the elections. As a result, it's creating a whole lot of chaos and havoc in the country. Take, for example, what happened a few hours ago. The firing of Chief Justice Walter Onoge. Buhari doesn't really have the legal right to fire this individual, but he took it upon himself to fire Chief Justice Walter Onoge because he's already calculating that in case any issue arises with the rigging of elections, Chief Justice Walter Onoge will be the one in charge of handling this matter. So he wanted to bring somebody from his own area in the north who can really handle the legal front for him. So in case of an election dispute, he will be able to have his favorite person to be in charge of this matter. If this happens, it's going to create a whole lot of havoc. We know Nigeria is not like Cameroon. Cameroon is a puppet French state. In Nigeria, there's no man who is powerful enough to go against the will of the people. Each time they have tried, the people bring them to order. They bring them in check. Look at the list of Nigerian leaders. No leader is ever greater than the people. So whenever you prove to be great, they bring you down. And this is the mistake Mr. Buhari is making. He was brought to be president again because people thought he was going to be a better solution to the security crisis in the country. For so many years now, Mr. Buhari has been ineffective in handling the security challenges facing Nigeria. He is thinking now that by rigging the elections, he'll be able to win a second term as a civilian leader. But we see that the people don't really want to vote for this individual. He's losing grounds every day. When you look at the press, even the Londoners, the Nigerians who are in England, their preference is Peter Obi and Atiku Abubakar. You can see the banners in London. They are all cheering for the opposition. So Mr. Buhari knows he's losing ground. So he's taking a whole lot of steps to try to do a few machinations so that he can put his people in place so that he can easily win re-election. This is going to create a whole lot of havoc because already so many people in the country, including former President Olusegun Obasanjo, they are watching him and they know that he is trying to rig the elections. So they know the kind of game he's going to play. If Buhari rigs the elections, what we foresee when we look at the crystal ball? Nigeria is going to go back to dictatorship. In his second term as a civilian leader, he's going to become a dictator the way he used to be when he was a military leader. And people already can foresee that because he doesn't like to look at the rule of law. Nigeria has a very democratic system. But the way this individual runs the country, he runs the country as if he is a military leader. Nigeria is supposed to have checks and balances, which you have in any good democratic system. Nigeria has a judiciary that is supposed to be free and fair. Nigeria has an executive. Then Nigeria also has a legislature. But when you look at all these three arms of government, Mr. Buhari is always trying to interfere everywhere, even in the executive branch. He's always interfering with local elections, who wins what election. He wants his own people to be in charge. So this is creating a whole lot of problems. But so far, the firing of Chief Justice Walter Onoge is really a watershed event because the Nigerian Bar Association is already against this action. The Nigerian Senate is also against this action. Then a lot of lawyers too are also rising against Mr. Buhari as a result of this firing. He tried to behave as if he did not only fire Mr. Onogen, Mr. Onogen resigned. Mr. Onogen himself has been saying that no, he was fired. He did not resign on his own. He was pushed out by Mr. Buhari. When we look at this action, it reminds us of what happened in Pakistan during the time of Pervez Musharraf. But Musharraf was a military leader. He fired the Chief Justice, and that brought the whole legal system to a halt. And we foresee that this is what is going to happen in Nigeria. Just less than 3 weeks before the election, Buhari is taking this kind of action. It is really unnecessary, and it is designed for Buhari's own selfish interests. Already, the Western world, the United States in particular, President Donald Trump has weighed in. The British also have weighed in. So have other colonial masters. They have weighed in. This is really an unconstitutional move. Anybody who understands the Nigerian constitution will tell you Buhari doesn't have the legal authority to fire the Chief Justice. There is a process which can result in the firing of the Chief Justice, but not by the president. So by firing the Chief Justice, Buhari has taken the law into his own hands. So he is not respecting the rule of law. So why should Mr. Buhari be above the law? That's the question we're asking on this show. By taking this action, Mr. Buhari is making Nigeria to become more lawless. Already, the security situation is very, very precarious. A lot of people are dying. Kidnapping is going on. And Buhari cannot really guarantee Nigerians the security that they voted him for. Nigeria is very, very lawless. And we can tell you this when you look at the images that are on social media every day. You see what is happening in the country. People are really afraid for the future of this country. We don't want this country to break apart. Nigeria is a populous country. It is one of the richest countries in Africa. So we want some kind of stability and order to return to this homeland. Okay? And we think the Atiku Abubakar and Peter Obi ticket may be the ticket that can really bring normalcy back to the country. They may not be perfect, but we think they will bring change that Nigerians are clamoring for. Already, the young people like Sowore Omoyele and Fela Dutorye, they have been trying to bring some noise so that people can hear what they have to say, but nobody is hearing them. They're just drowning the noise and nobody is really hearing these young people. They could really help the young people to vote. So we're encouraging young Nigerians to give a chance to the young politicians because they represent the future. Most of the old politicians cannot really offer you much. They just have the old stuff. They are not really offering any positive change. So we are telling you, vote for the young people who want to rule Nigeria. Give them a chance. They are the future, okay?
$250 to $6,000. Quick tax refund advance made easy. It's tax season 2019. The Christmas and New Year holidays are over. Everybody's talking about the PJ Tax Service, the new kid in town on H&R Block's block. Why? Money, money, money. Spread the good news. Quick tax refund advance is here. It's big, bigger than ever. Put big money in your pocket fast. PJ Tax Service. Nobody gets your tax money back faster. Instantly, quickly, and immediately. Three tax refund disbursement choices for you in less than 24 hours. Visa e-card, paper check, and direct deposit. Get your money back without delays. PJ Tax Service has your back. It is your money, so get it now. PJ Tax Service. You like the way we do your taxes. PJ Tax Service. You feel like a lottery or a sweepstake winner. Act now. Call 301-593-4879 or 301-593-4897. Or come to our office, 11207A, Lockwood Drive, Silver Spring, Maryland, 20901. Or you can visit us online, www.pjtaxservice.com.
So next, we're going to draw your attention to a particular problem dealing with lawlessness in Nigeria. We've been telling you on this show previously that the Buhari government committed an illegal act without the consent of refugees. Buhari sent these people to Cameroon to be killed against their will. So this was an illegal act, and a few days ago, the Nigerian court had to hear lawyers who had to discuss this matter. who were told that the lawyers were saying that the case has been adjourned until April. So this is another example of Mr. Buhari's callous way of behaving in a lawless manner. And we think this needs to stop. If Nigerians can vote this individual out, even if he tries to rig the elections, the whole world will see. And we trust Nigerians. We know Nigerians are going to do the right thing. They will kick Buhari out. We want to move now to the next country. For a few weeks now, we've been talking to you about what is happening in Cameroon, La République du Cameroun. La République du Cameroun is a country that was formed as a result of the coming together of two territories, the French territory and the British territory. But so far, one individual has been the strong man in that part of the world. His name is Paul Biya. He has been running the country by himself as a dictator without allowing any opposition. So far, the Ambazonians have been fighting because of marginalization. For over 2 years, Mr. Paul Biya and his army have been unable to crush this rebellion. So now the rebellion has even morphed into a full-scale civil war, a fratricidal war, a war where brother is killing brother. It is true, not all Cameroonians agree with this war. Already, the war is splitting Cameroonians into two camps. Even in the army, we see a lot of fissures. People are breaking. You have the Bulu group, and of course you have the non-Beti group. The Bulu group are going for the killing of Cameroonians because they are trying to protect their tribe. But the people who are in the army who are not part of the Bulu clan, they don't want to see the slaughtering of innocent people every day. They want this to stop. We have predicted to you before that this Ambazonia crisis is going to be the downfall of the Biya regime. And already, with the arrest of Professor Maurice Kamto a few days ago in Douala, our dreams of problems for Biya have really been realized. We're telling you this many months ago that the problem in Ambazonia is going to spill over into the Francophone zone. Today, we're having a Francophone crisis. For so many months, the Francophones have just been complaining about the loss of the election. Professor Maurice Kamto actually won the election. But Mr. Biya, as he normally does, fake victory. The Constitutional Council, which is handpicked by him, nominated him as a new president. So, the Francophones now have started clamoring for change. They have been protesting. So Mr. Maurice Kamto went to Douala to support his people who were protesting. And he was arrested in the house of one of his supporters. And people don't really know what has happened to him so far. But we know that this is just the beginning of a problem. This is the awakening of a sleeping giant. The Anglophones are a small minority, but the Francophones are very big. They make up a big portion of the country. So it's not going to be the same kind of game. And the Bamlekis, where Maurice Kamto comes from, are a very resourceful people. In fact, they are the richest people in Cameroon through their own hard work. They do not steal like the Bulu people who support Paul Biya. These people work hard every day. They own the biggest businesses, and they do this by bootstrapping all their efforts. They raise themselves up by their own bootstraps, so the government doesn't give them any handouts. So these are the people that Mr. Biya has a war against now. So what is happening in Douala? A lot of people have been arrested. Even the lawyer who spoke for Mr. Maurice Kamto during the Constitutional Council session at the court, Michel Ndoki, was shot many times in the leg. When you see those pictures, you can see how barbaric this Biya government can be. They're killing people left and right, thinking that by intimidating them, they will cower into submission. But it's like they have lighted a big fire, which is burning the whole country apart. Now, in places like Douala and Yaoundé, there's no more peace in Francophone Cameroon. They were thinking that the problem in Ambazonia will be limited to the southern Cameroons, but now this problem has spilled into the Francophone area, and the fire is burning and burning and burning. So when you look at the pictures of what is happening now, it looks like things are even getting worse. In most of the foreign capitals, supporters of Mr. Maurice Kamto and other Cameroonians have been taking over the Cameroonian embassy. Okay? They have been breaking things because they want to protest. They want the world to notice that there are problems in Cameroon. So far, most of these colonial governments like France I've just been watching from the sidelines, and Mr. Bia is killing innocent Cameroonians, and they're not saying anything about it. We think this will stop very, very soon because the people are really taking the law into their own hands. If the international community cannot protect them, they want to really protect themselves. They want to really fight. And they are taking the fight to Mr. Bia. He used to say, as one French journalist asked him, why is it that you are in power for too long? And he said, rester au pouvoir, c'est qui peut pas qui veut. He's in power because he can. It's not just because you like to be in power. You have to show that you are a tough guy before you can stay in power. So that's a translation in English. He thinks because I'm powerful, I can be president. So the world is now for the survival of the fittest. So he's a strong man. But the days of the strong man are numbered because the way the people are taking things, things are not really going lightly for this individual, Mr. Paul Bia, because the army is killing people, but already the people now will take arms. So one prediction I will make on this show today. In a few weeks, the Bamlikis and their supporters would start bearing arms against this Bia government. So mark my words, I always predict these things and people don't believe it until it happens. So watch my words again. In a few weeks, the Bamlikis will not only rise in protest, they will start taking up arms against the Bia government because they're not just going to sit and watch Mr. Bia kill them in droves. And they have the resources, probably more than the Ambazonians. And the Bamlikis have a lot of solidarity. You can already see their numbers in Europe and other parts of the world. They're going to take the fight now to Mr. Bia. So it seems the Ambazonians now have a common friend. Their common friend now is Francophone Cameroon. These people are against Bia. The Ambazonians are against Bia. So when you have a friend who is against your enemy, he's a true friend because both of you now are fighting a common enemy. So we don't really worry about what will happen after the Francophones and the Ambazonians kick Mr. Bia out. Then they will have to come to terms with how to form a new country and build for the future.
Life insurance money secrets of millionaires and billionaires exposed. Discover how America's rich and famous exploit these arcane tools to build fabulous wealth. Why should these big white guys have all the fun? Let Prince Ojong, the celebrity author of The Miraculous Millionaire, show you the little understood life insurance way to riches. Are you still doubting the good things that life insurance can do for you? Trust strategies, estate planning, 401k rollover, annuity contract, cash value, education funding, executive benefits, income protection, life protection, living benefits, mortgage protection, tax-free retirement? Think and grow rich with life insurance. Your amazing journey to wealth begins by calling Prince Ojong at 240-350-1131.
So now, we're going to take this issue of lawlessness now to Congo DRC because we've been covering Congo DRC quite a few times on this show. We've shown you what has been happening in Congo DRC. Felix Tshisekedi was elected president, so that was good news. But underneath the good news, we really want you to look at what may happen, okay? So we're going to give you a crystal ball. The difference between us and other shows is that we can predict events. We will look at statistics. We look at what is happening. We have a good knowledge of African history. So we can really tell you what is going to happen in this part of the world. And trust us, we're going to tell you. So there was a peaceful election. Yes. The election was peaceful because Mr. Felix Tshisekedi struck a satanic or a Faustian deal with Joseph Kabila. Joseph Kabila is not really going into the sunset. So he will just sit behind the scenes and control things using strings. Because when you look at the composition of the government, that's going to tell you who is going to be the prime minister, who are going to be the key ministers. But no matter what Felix Tshisekedi does, he is a slave. He is a slave of Mr. Kabila. Because Mr. Kabila is not going to give him free reign of the government. What is going to happen is he will have limited authority. But the challenge is, can you have two presidents in a country? That's never going to happen. So this coalition that is happening now between the Tshisekedis and the Kabilas is not going to last for long. After a while, Mr. Tshisekedi would really want to be president. He would not just want to be a puppet of Mr. Kabila's. Because this is what happens. It's the same thing that happened even with Mr. Kabila's father, Laurent Kabila. When the Rwandans put him in power, they thought they would have a puppet who would be listening to them. Before long, Laurent Kabila wanted to be a president, not just in name. He wanted to be a real president with a lot of power. So he started exercising his power. So we are predicting that this is what is going to happen between Mr. Joseph Kabila and Mr. Felix Tshisekedi. This coalition is going to break apart. Already, when you look at the politics in the country, Mr. Kabila's party dominates the parliament. So it will be difficult for Mr. Tshisekedi to do much with that dominance in the parliament. So what is going to be happening is, in the short run, Mr. Tshisekedi is going to always defer to Mr. Kabila before he takes any major action. But it will not take long. Mr. Tshisekedi is going to be longing to be a real president. He will want to have control. And then, of course, we have a lot of issues in Congo that are creating lawlessness. As we are taping the show this morning, news came to our studio about students who were killed in the University of Lubumbashi. Okay? So already in the East, which has always been the hotbed of political lawlessness and confusion, a lot of things are happening. When you look at Goma, Kisangani, Kivu, that whole area which forms a frontier with countries like Uganda, Angola. So you see a whole lot of problems because that Rwanda is always fighting these guys. So when we look at this, already Felix Tshisekedi has a lot of trouble in his hands because for all the years Mr. Joseph Kabila was in power, he was never able to get rid of the rebels who were in the East. All these people are fighting for financial resources because this place has a lot of gold, diamond, and coltan. So they want money from these resources. In fact, Angola and some of the people who support Rwanda, they have been benefiting a lot from the resources of Congo DRC, which is why there's always trouble in the East. When you look at most of the minefields, the Africans are working there for almost nothing. The people are very, very poor. They are the ones working in those minefields. We can even show you pictures of people getting dirty, just digging for diamond in that whole area. So it's really sickening when you look at what is happening. And it will continue to happen because the resources in that place, the people will be fighting for those resources. So Congo DRC is not really going to have any peace anytime soon. So we're just letting you know this. So if you're hoping that there will be peace in Congo DRC anytime soon, you're dreaming. So this problem will continue. And we don't think Mr. Felix Tshisekedi is strong enough or savvy enough to be able to manage the problems in that area. Those problems will overcome him, and we are predicting that more rebels will take over the East and they will start moving towards Kinshasa and there will be more problems. So we've spent some time to just give you a highlight. So how do we solve the issue of lawlessness in Africa? The issue can be solved if we try to create a country of law, a country where the rule of law dominates. Such a country has to be a democracy where you have elections which are free and fair. No strong man should be deciding the fate of the country. Then there should be stability in the social order. Then, of course, economics. In economics, we look at what we call compassionate capitalism. Africans need to start believing in compassionate capitalism. Capitalism with a heart. When I look at capitalism, I'm looking at capitalism as defined by Professor Max Weber. Max Weber, he looks at capitalism as a system of private enterprise which believes in the utilization of the factors of production to create unlimited amount of profit. So that's the way I look at capitalism. But this system should also have a heart. We should be helpful to our neighbors. We should not just take with all the greed. We should try to help each other. If we can do this, then we'll realize that we can start building a new African nation, an African nation that has a lot of resources. In our next show, we're going to give you a blueprint on how to build a new African nation. We're going to be recruiting our Africa 100, people who want to be millionaire apprentices. We're going to teach them different areas of knowledge so that they can start being free. We thank you very much for watching this show today, and we're asking you to subscribe to our channel and to share this show with your friends. So many good things are going to be happening. Feel free to contact us on YouTube And you can also call our office number. We thank you very much for watching this show once again. Subscribe, and share the show with your friends. Thank you very much.
Selling a service or a product? Need buyers? Use the African Nation TV as a channel to reach many viewers. Act now and call Prince Ojong at 240-350-1131. That's 240-350-1131. Act today.